Greetings and salutations, my friends. My name's Ollie, and here is your loaf of daily bread. Today's loaf of bread comes to us by way of Hubert Reeves, a Canadian astrophysicist, and he says the following. Man is the most insane species. He worships an invisible god and destroys a visible nature. Unaware that this nature he's destroying is this god he's worshiping. I feel like the majority of people who consider themselves godly are missing the point. I think that a lot of people are worshiping a symbol, a metaphor, without actually realizing what the metaphor or symbol stands for. As I've said time and time again in these videos, my personal view is that the God of the Old Testament, the God of Abraham, which is also the same God that is worshipped by Jews, Muslims, and Christians, I believe that the God described in those books is a metaphor for nature. Apparently, Hubert Reeves has a similar notion. I've made these points before, but I'll repeat them very briefly. Number one, God, like nature, is everywhere, is everything, is all-powerful. Makes sense? Everything that exists exists in nature. Everything that exists was created by nature and is encompassed by nature. God makes it rain on the just and the unjust alike. To me, that's a big giveaway, because that's what nature does. Nature gives out blessings, but she also gives out ass whoopings. And she doesn't seem to be very selective with respect to which she gives to whom. Bad shit happens to great people. Great stuff happens to shitty people. There's no rhyme or reason to it because nature doesn't follow these definitions of good and bad the way humans do. So while we're all over here arguing about whose God is the real God and what God wants us to do, we're destroying this very real manifestation of the divine as we go along with our wars, with our pollution, with the craziness that we do. We're actually damaging the planet, this manifestation of nature. There is no God outside of nature. Nature is God, and I don't see any other way to look at it. And this doesn't reduce God in any way. If anything, it makes God even more amazing, more wonderful, more awesome. Because as scientists will tell you, the moment you begin to objectively study the creation and to get to know the creator, you realize that there are wonders within wonders within wonders waiting to be discovered by the curious minds of intrepid truth seekers. The God of the Old Testament is a small-minded God. It's a God that is produced by a limited imagination and limited scope of knowledge. We have to update the metaphor, my friends, and I think looking at it the way Hubert Reeves does is much more productive and conducive to our overall well-being as a species. It puts us in the proper place, not as original sinners, not as the playthings of some vengeful and jealous deity, but as the manifestations of God, and as such we contain that divine essence within ourselves. There is no separating us from nature. Nature works from within us. We contain the very essence of that power, of that divine force that made the entire universe. To me, that's much more awesome than believing in the literal interpretation of Eden. Like God got bored one day and just decided to carve up a dude out of clay and breathe into his lungs. Again, that's more metaphor in my humble opinion, because we are made of the earth. Well, again, that's a little bit small-minded and a little bit limited in scope. We're not just made out of the soil and the earth and the minerals in this world. We're made out of stardust. So yeah, I think we need to update the metaphor, my friends. We need to come up with something a little bit more current, a little bit more accurate, and a little bit more conducive to feeling awe and wonder, not only at the world and the universe around us, but at ourselves. We are special. We are different. There's something in us that is not in other species, and we would do well to not only honor that thing, but align ourselves with it. That's what I think. Always happy to hear your thoughts, though, so drop them in the comments below, and I will respond. Until next time, live well, my friends.